Hi, I wanted to get in front of the camera and meet you personally and give you a little bit of background on my husband and myself and our preparation journey, kind of what it's looked like for us. You know, if you're watching this, you might be thinking, well, these people have always lived this way, or they were raised like this, or, you know, so I can't do it. The truth is, I got to give you some history about us. And also, if I'm frowning, it's because I'm outside, obviously, and facing the sun. So I'm sorry. Real quick. If a wasp comes too close to me, I'm booking it. I'm flying over there because I'll swell up like a watermelon. So just, you know, and I can't edit. So just give me some grace and realize I don't like wasps. And it, up here, I don't think I have any Benadryl or anything to help me get over my reaction. Okay. Side note, both my husband and I have very similar childhood upbringings. We both were raised by single mothers, and which meant we nothing against single moms, because I know a lot of single moms had no choice. Well, they had, they do a very good job. For what both of our moms did, they did great. But what that meant was we had to figure a lot of things out for ourselves, and while they were trying to earn money to keep a roof over our heads, we were both, I didn't know him, he didn't know me, but we were both out kind of figuring it out as we went. So we didn't get really taught skills from mom or dad that prepared us for what we felt like was coming. My husband for the last 25 years has, and that's how long we've been married, I've been blessed to be married to a wonderful man, he has known something's on the horizon. And that things are about to change, and I think that we're seeing some things, especially in America, but definitely globally, that are happening that prove that. So we are not conspiracy theorists. We're not out thinking that everybody's going to come get us, but we do feel like that man was created to be a little bit more in touch with the creation that he was offered to be a good steward of. And that we as a society have kind of gotten away from that and relied on Big Brother, whether that's government, whether that's conveniences, whether that's status quo, keeping up with the Joneses, whatever you want to call it. And so we have been on what we call a preparation journey, and it's kind of ramped up the last few years, and I'll tell you why. I've been blessed to marry a visionary, and if you're married to a visionary, ladies, you need to understand you're either going to be really rich or really poor. And we've been both. We've had, my husband has been a millionaire twice, and we have had $8 in our bank account more often than necessary. So I knew when I was getting married to him it was never going to be boring, and it hasn't been. It's been a great ride for 25 years, and I'm looking forward to 25 more. But that's a side note. The fact is, we're not trained, raised to live up in the hills or live on back to basics life. So we have been learning skills for the last few years, and now we are given the opportunity to put a lot of them to practice by having this ancestral land of my husband's. We're not roughing it like living in tents, but we do have a lot less amenities than most of the 21st century people our age have. And we're in our 40s, still barely there. And so we don't have a dishwasher now, we don't have air conditioning or heat, electric heat, central heat and air. We have, I'll show you tomorrow, we have an issue with our indoor plumbing, and we're learning an awful lot. And we've always gardened, piddled with it a little bit, learned and always had to stretch during those lean times because, you kind of find that you live to the amount of money that you make, which is kind of sad. I'd like to say that we understood that when we had plenty of money, we put plenty back. And we did okay, but when it came down to having nothing, you end up using what you put back. I know somebody out there is agreeing with me on this one, because you know you've done it too, and it's kind of a scary situation to be in. That's where your faith really comes in, and you just kind of walk by faith and not by the sight of your bank account. But we have part of our preparation journey has been to purge ourselves of luxury items, and some items people would really consider luxury that we did purge up. Baby grand piano, leather sofa set, an RV, a boat, $1 million home. We got out of that one, which was great. We didn't lose that one, we just got out of it. You know, some of these luxury items we have gotten rid of. A lot of people think, oh yeah, I'm going to build a garden, or I'm going to go on preparation, and God has me doing this, or there's something coming down the pike. But they're still spending $500 a week for organic groceries. Or they are not willing to part with some of their material belongings. Our preparation journey has looked like getting rid of a lot of material belongings. And you know what? It's pretty freeing in a lot of ways. I own a successful business. My husband helps me run that. He owns a successful business. We are not just backwoods hiding out, you know, trying to pretend like the world's going to pot and belly up any second. We are still engaged in society. We aren't hiding. But that's kind of what our preparation journey is all about, is networking with others. And I know some of you I have met personally, and some of you I met online, and we hopefully will be able to meet face to face. But our preparation journey is more about skills, about the ability, about preparing ourselves to be at peace when the world around us seems like it's in turmoil. And a lot of that does mean being a good steward of what you've been blessed with. Not all blessing is money. Often it's the blessing of learning a character trait, the blessing of learning a skill, the blessing of having close friends that you do know you can count on when things are difficult. There are blessings that are not measurable by any stretch of the imagination by a dollar sign. So if you are struggling right now with finances, take a look around you and see if you don't have some things you could probably get rid of. I know there are a lot of one-of-a-kind items. There are a lot of sentimental items. We have plenty. We have a lot. But you have to keep them all. I heard someone say once, you know, but I'll never be able to replace it. Well, that might be true. But is it worth holding on to when you can't feed your family? So those are some of the things that we have faced in our preparation journey. Hopefully, once my husband gets a few things ironed out here, he'll sit down and talk with you guys too, and you'll have the honor of meeting my husband. And if you by any chance you're here and you want to check out my business, it's not really a business, it's more of a sharing, but it's connected to what I do for a living. You can go over to The Wheat Guy on YouTube. Just take a look for that. And you can pick up some good tips to stretch your dollars, because if you're in preparation like we are, got to stretch everything you got. Anyway, hope you enjoy our journey. I'm looking around and I see some wasps coming. So I'm going to go. And I'll see you guys the next time. Bye.